Hi everyone, Pete Calamane here. Thank you so much for taking your time and watching this video. So for those who do not know me, just a small introduction before we get into these 12 simple steps to successfully finish a PCB layout for production. So I've been in electronics for 10 years. I started my company 4 years ago in 2017. I'm loving what I'm doing every day. Electronics is my passion. And I'm happy that I can do this every day and reach the goals for my customers. But along the way, I have made a lot of mistakes. I have to be very honest in that. Made a lot of mistakes. And my aim today is with these 12 simple steps is to help you avoid some of the mistakes that you can make while you are designing a PCB and especially when you are finishing a PCB. So just a quick overview. These are some of my stories. I will not tell you all these stories. These stories are in my online coaching program, but I would like to highlight one specific story. It still keeps me awake at night from time to time. And that's the last story over here. That's the four-layer design that was produced with two layers. So it all comes down to having a predictable, proven process when you're doing electronic design. At that time, we were doing a specific custom design for a customer. So basically, we did not start from scratch. We used a PCB layout that they already had made. We made some changes to that. And then we started producing these PCBs. So after some prototyping, we saw the errors in the existing PCB. We changed that and we made the PCB. Now, all good. The PCBs were produced. This was quite a big batch that has been produced of PCBs, quite an investment for our company at that time. And when the PCBs got delivered to the customer, they told us they are not working. And if we were sure that we had produced them with the correct amount of layers. So it turned out they had given us a four-layer design in the beginning. And we had extracted this as a two-layer design. So again, I can imagine if you're in electronics, this is a huge mistake to make. So we produced it with two layers less. We never checked it or had no process in place to check it. And only after the production, we got to the conclusion that there was something missing there and that we had produced it with two layers less. So of course, this is one of the biggest mistakes that I have ever made. There are smaller mistakes as well, but these mistakes, they cost you a lot of money in the process, a lot of time, and there's a lot of friction at your customer side as well. So I want to avoid that. And along the process, what I have made for myself is what I call the production-ready design flow, productization-ready design flow. And basically everything that I do from the beginning, from an idea all the way to production, large volume production, is now in a process. It's a clear process. It is a step-by-step process. And if I go through every step, I will avoid every possible mistake that I have made in the past. So there's a specific checklist today that I want to highlight with you, and that's the PCB finishing checklist. So again, the main idea behind this is if you want to bake a cake, if you have a recipe, the start is the ingredients and you will have a correct cake or a good tasting cake at the end. While going through the recipe. The exact same thing is true for electronics. If you have a correct recipe, you follow every step. And of course, if you have the necessary expertise, you end up with a good result. So today, I'm going to show you my PCB layout finishing checklist. That's what I call the 12 simple steps to successfully finish a PCB layout for production. So let's go into that. Normally, you are now on this link watching this video on this page. And here I have listed the 12 steps that I use for layout finishing. Now, to be clear, there's a lot of extra checks that I use. There's manufacturability checks, testability checks, and then checks before going into production. So for instance, the mistake with the four layers produced as a two layer, that is another checklist, an extra checklist that I do before going into production. This checklist that you see over here, that's really to be used if you have a PCB, like the example I have right here, almost ready to be finished, almost ready to make the production files. There's some important things here that you need to check before you make these files. So let's have a look. The 12 steps that I use to verify that. So the first of all, the first step is the copper pour. So did you do a copper pour on top side for instance, the power plane and on bottom side for the ground plane? So this is especially true in a two-layer design. I know if you're using a four-layer design, typically your power and your ground plane are internally. There's no real need to have a copper pour on top and bottom. On the other hand, if you're using a two-layer design, you should certainly not forget to put a copper pour over there. So that's the first step. What you're seeing over here, this is a four-layer design. So there is no real copper pour in there, but I wanted to give you an example of a copper pour. So I have made a small one over here under this connectivity module. What you would do in a two-layer design is, of course, you would use the complete plane and make that a power plane. So that's the first step, first check that I do. If all is checked, you can always use this page if you like. I'm more than happy to share this with you. You can click this button, we checked our copper pour. Step number two, keep clear distances. Did you respect the keep clear distances from mounting holes and other large components? So an important one here, let's go to our 3D view. If there's larger components on your board, for instance, there's a screw, let's say, that you need to put into the side here of the board, there should be a sufficient clearance with your components. It cannot be too close. So from time to time, before I had this checklist, I made the mistake to putting it too close, and then it was interfering with the components. So you don't want that. You want to check that the keep clear distance is respected. If that's done, go ahead and check it. Step number three, tracks on the board edge. Depends a bit on the manufacturer that you're using, type of process that you're using. My manufacturer, typically I need to have tracks not closer than 0.25 millimeters from the edge of the board. So that's something again to check. You would check that in a 2D view, see if everything is not too close to the board edge. If that is checked, go ahead and click that button. Next up, step number four is silkscreen placement. Place the silkscreen text and check correct placement and readability. Include the customer logo as well. So I find this a very important one. Not so bad if you make the mistake if you're doing automatic assembly, but especially if you're going to do manual assembly, this will save you a lot of time. So of course the silk, that's the text, let's say the white text that is on your board. What you want to have is a clear indication of what component is where. So for instance, if I zoom in over here, I think that's a good example. I have two resistors that are quite close to each other. If you would take away the components, let's see if that works. You cannot be 100% sure if they need to be oriented horizontally or vertically. You know, you can see it because there's a short over here, but typically you would not know. So that's why I always place my text in the same orientation as my resistors. So that's a very small trick, but feel free to use it. It's a very handy trick. So you see over here it's horizontal, over here it's vertical. So I know if I'm going to do this soldering manually, how the component has to be placed without having to look at my PCB design. So that's one thing. Another thing is to make a clear specifier or descriptor of the PCB. So I have that here on the bottom side. This is a simple descriptor in my case. Let's zoom out completely. So it's called TC underscore smart traffic light, and then some extra indicators. The indicators are especially important for me to know what version of the PCB I'm looking at, what bill of materials. Okay, so when that is done, well, we already tackled step five as well. We add a clear descriptor, PCB descriptor in silk. Step number six is place the fiducials, at least one, preferably three per side of the board. Very, very important step, a very easy step to forget. But your manufacturer will not be too happy. So in my case, the fiducials are here on the sides. I always try to put in three so that I have a nice triangle there if possible. And this will then be used by your manufacturer to align the PCB. Again, very easy to forget, but if you need to do a rerun of your PCB just because of the fiducials, you will be happy that you did the checks using this checklist. So we did that, that's okay. Step number seven is via tenting. Depends a bit on your design, but typically I like to tent all the vias on my board to avoid possibilities for short circuits. So important check to make if you want that. Some people need to have exposed vias in one of their designs. In that case, of course, you leave them exposed, but typically you can live with all the vias tented. And if you need some points to connect to, you put a test point on there. Then step number eight is the board outline. Again, very important for the people that are going to manufacture your PCBs. Draw a clear PCB outline in a mechanical layer and include it in your production files. So that means that you need to make sure that you have a mechanical layer clearly indicating. In this case, it's a simple one. You have the let's say the square. But the important thing over here is I have a specific cutout to have a thermal isolation there. This cutout needs to be defined in your mechanical layer as well, so that this is very clear. In that case, that's a green that you see over here. In that case, your manufacturer of the PCBs knows exactly what is happening, knows the dimensions. So there we go. Step number 9, maybe an obvious one, but you should not forget it. It's to do a final design rule check. So go ahead, do the DRC check, see if everything is still okay. You never know by tenting vias that you maybe have moved one, or by shifting the silk that you maybe moved something in your PCB. So make sure that you do a final DRC check. Step number 10, so we can check that. Step number 10 is then a final sanity check. So perform a final sanity check with your customer or another design engineer. Typically, you're doing a layout, PCB layout on yourself, maybe schematic design on yourself, but it's often very interesting just to talk about your design with somebody else. And because of you explaining some stuff, you will already see where there might be some hiccups or some issues. And of course, if you have two pairs of eyes looking at one PCB layout, you will of course see more possibilities for errors and will be able to avoid them. So an important step, I always like to do that, even if I'm working alone on a project. Then step number 11, a very interesting one is to print out a PCB on a one-to-one scale and see if special components fit correctly and if it fits the housing as well. So in this case, again, it's not too difficult, a PCB, but sometimes you have oval PCBs or PCBs with cutouts and it has to fit exactly in a housing. In that case, it's very interesting to just make a one-on-one print of this PCB, see if it fits in the housing. Same is true for specific components. Let's say you're not too sure on this SIM card holder footprint. Well, what you can do is you just order the SIM card holder, you do a one-on-one print of your PCB, put it on top, see if it fits. Again, very simple check, but I have done a lot of reruns on PCBs just because of a PCB was a bit too high, a bit too low. I think if you have made PCB layouts, you know the story. So for me, for the rest of my life, this is in my checklist, the one-on-one print check. And then the last step is production go. So I always like to have an official go from my customer. That can be an external customer or an internal customer, depending a bit on what type of business you're working. But I like to have an official go. Everybody's happy about the PCB that has been designed, about the result, and everybody's committing to put it into production. As a PCB layouter, it's good. Of course, you need to take your responsibility, but it's good to have this, let's say, shared responsibility of going into production, everybody agreeing with what you have done. So for me, that's a very quick overview of the 12 steps here, the 12 checks that I do to finish a PCB. Of course, there's much more things involved if you want to have a bit more more depth there about manufacturability, testability, and so forth and so on. You can click this image here below to learn a bit more. Now, just to give you a conclusion, we have implemented this with Centineo at a few customers last year. So these are just three examples. We did it with one customer. We implemented the strategy. The strategy, that means the complete process flow, of course, not just these 12 steps, but all the processes, all the checklists involved to completely have this productization ready design flow. So that's much more than just the 12 steps. Now this customer, they went from a random design process to a structured process, and the design finalization, they used to need 2 months to finish a PCB. Now, because of the fact that they are able to implement the complete process, they have the flows, they're able to do it in 2 weeks. That's an impressive result. Very happy to see these results. Another customer, they implemented the strategy. For them, the result was it enabled them to be in budget and before deadline the first time in years. So again, simple stuff. Again, the same story. If you have the recipe to bake a cake, the result is a tasting cake. Same is true in electronics design. Then a last customer success story was a startup customer. They did not have a very big capital or budget to start what they had in mind that a customer would need, and they used a strategy. Now, this customer was able to determine the real customer needs instead of blowing up the budget. So they had some specific electronic system in mind, but what they saw just by going through the process flow for this specification prototyping phase is that in fact they were not matching the market needs. So they implemented the strategy and they were able to shift it to a correct device. So that's a very brief overview. I hope you learned something. I hope you can use these 12 simple steps to successfully finish a PCB layout for production. So very nice meeting you. Thanks for taking your time today. And if you want to learn more, you can always click the image below and learn a bit more in depth about that complete process. Thanks. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.